Videos of Tensegrity structures have been very popular on YouTube recently, and some of these videos have got millions of views. These type of structures give the impression of a gravity-defying witchcraft, so I thought to myself, why don't I make one and try to understand how it works, and hopefully this video will get some good views too. So I will start this video by making a simple version of these types of structures using crafting sticks and sewing threads, followed by computer modeling a structural analysis software. What makes this structure interesting is that all connections between the top and bottom frames are through very thin threads which can only take axial tension. I have created this computer model in a structural analysis software to understand it better. In terms of the natural frequency taken from the model analysis, the frequency of the first mode is very low, which indicates that the structure is not very stiff laterally, and that is what we can observe easily from our simple crafting stick model. By having a quick look at the axial forces, we can see that the center thread is having the highest tension among all the threads. To better understand the behavior, let's try this structure without the center thread. As you have guessed, the structure will be unstable since the threads will go into compression which they cannot resist. This confirms that the center thread is the main tensional element in holding up the top frame. Now let's look at this structure with the center thread only. In this case, as you can imagine, the top frame is simply hung from the base below. However, this structure in this form will be unstable as well since there is no element to resist the top frame rotations. This is because the thread does not have any rotational stiffness and cannot resist any moment and shear to prevent the rotations of the top frame. To make the structure stable in this form, we need to replace the thread with a more rigid element and make sure that its both ends are rigidly connected to the other parts of the structure. This experiment tells us that the corner threads are providing some sort of lateral stability for the top frame. When the top frame is supported by the center thread, it tends to move to the side and hence it engages the opposite threads. This can be seen easier by applying a small load on one side of the structure. When the top frame is pushed down on one side, the threads on the opposite side will get engaged in tension and prevent a further downward movement of the top frame. Well, I guess this is all I have for this experiment, and I hope you learned something new. So until the next video, have a great day or night.